As you know, the past couple weeks we've been talking about pride and humility. We've been looking at the different manifestations of pride and humility that we find in this great resource, From Pride to Humility, from Dr. Stuart Scott, that you can order, and I encourage you to order for yourself. And the past week, last week, we looked at the first 10 manifestations of humility. And this week we're going to look at the following 8 manifestations that Dr. Scott lines out in his resource here. But before we do that, I wanted just to give us a biblical example of humility and Christ being our greatest example of what humility looks like. And so in Philippians 2, 6 through 8, it says this. It says, "Who," speaking of Christ, "although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a bondservant, and being made in the likeness of men, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross." Christ is our King and our example of what it looks like to worship God and to put others above ourselves. And his example in Scripture is the one that we follow when it comes to this attribute of humility. And so as we continue on looking at different manifestations of humility, I want you just to keep that in your mind of what it looked like, how God himself, who had every right to be exalted above all of us, because of his love and because of his humility, he emptied himself to the point of death so that we would have an opportunity to be reconciled to God through his death and resurrection. And so as we look at our next 8 manifestations of humility, I just want you to begin to think through different ways that God may be calling you to put away pride and instead take on humility that comes from him and him alone. Number 11, manifestation from Dr. Scott's book, says, "Talking about others only if it is good or for their good. A humble person will speak well of others, not negatively. He will convey something negative about someone only if he must do so in order to help the person." Proverbs 11:13 is our reference here. And so speaking about others only if it's good about them or good for them. The next one, being gladly submissive and obedient to those in authority. Humble people are first of all obedient to God and then the authorities over them. Romans 12:1-2 and Romans 13:1-2 are great examples of this. And so being faithful and submissive to those that God has put over us in authority. Number 13, preferring others over yourself. Humble people are willing to put others before self without first considering their own rights. Romans 12:10. Preferring others over yourself. It is normal in our culture, in our world, to put self first. But God calls us to think of others as more than ourselves and to prefer what they would like. Prefer what would be most loving to them over your own preferences. The next one, being thankful for criticism or reproof. Being thankful for criticism or reproof. Humble people view reproof as good for them and consider that God may be trying to teach them something. Proverbs 9:8 or Proverbs 27:5-6 are great references here. It's tough when somebody points out something that's wrong or a flaw in your character. But in humility, we want to grow closer to God and we know that we're flawed and we're sinful. And so we see it as a benefit or as something loving when someone points out an area that we could do better in. The next one, having a teachable spirit. Having a teachable spirit. Humble people realize they don't know everything, and even when they think they are right, are willing to consider that they might be wrong. 1 Corinthians 4:7 is a great reference here. Also, they also know that God can use anyone to teach them. Since he was even able to use a donkey to teach Balaam in Numbers 22, chapter 22, verse 22 through 35. They have many people they admire and respect. So having a teachable spirit, it's not about knowing everything. It's about being a learner. The next one, seeking always to build up others. A humble person always seeks to build up others. Humble people encourage others. They use only words that build up and say what is necessary for the edification of others. They never cut others down. Ephesians 4:29. Remember, pride usually comes out in sarcasm or demeaning language. But a humble person seeks to encourage and build up. The next one, serving. Humble people are on the lookout for ways to serve and assist others. They are the first to volunteer for jobs no one else wants. They take the initiative to reach out and to serve others. Galatians 5:13 is a great example here. We're often wanting to be served, and when something's less desirable to do, it feels good to let someone else do it. But if we're humble and we're looking to love others well, we'll step up and do the hard things and put others above ourselves. And last but not least for today, a quickness in admitting when you are wrong is evidence of humility. A quickness in admitting when you are wrong. Humble people have no problem with saying, "I was wrong. You're right. Thank you for telling me." Proverbs 29:23 is our reference here. So my encouragement to you today is to consider what it looks like to be humble and to strive to love God and to serve others above your own needs. Freedom comes from humility. And so my hope for you is to continue to find freedom in Christ.